So to make this a little bit more formal, we're going to specify sort of all the elements of an HMM. You've already sort of seen them. N is going to be the number of states. So S1 through SN is our set of states. So that's like sunny, rainy, snowy. And then there is a notion of a state sequence written as Q. And the idea is that Q sub I is whatever state I'm at time I. Okay? So when I say Q sub 3 equals S2, what that means is at time step 3, I'm in the second state. All right? Given a state, I can talk about the full specification of an HMM. And for whatever reason, HMMs are referred to as lambda. It's a triplet made up of three components that you've already seen. There's a state transition matrix. Those are the A's, the probability of going from one state at one time, given that you're at another state. There's the observation matrix, which before I was showing you as a discrete and was actually represented as a matrix. There's also a continuous version where your output is, you have a distribution over some feature vector for each state. So maybe it's, you're outputting some sort of measurement. And what you say is I've got one Gaussian in state one and different Gaussian in state two and a different Gaussian in state three. The idea is that for any given output, you can talk about the likelihood or the probability of given that output, given that you were in a particular state. And then the last thing you need is that initial distribution pi, right? That says what's the probability of starting at each and in particular state.